Hello students, welcome to Shree Classes, lecture number 8, current electricity, chapter number 12, CVC 10th. Today we will see the exemplar questions. Few questions we will try to solve. Let's have a look at the questions here. Electricity, the first question. I hope it is visible. Okay. A cell, a resistor, key, ammeter are arranged as shown in the circuit diagram. The current recorded in the ammeter will be maximum in 1, maximum in 2, maximum in 3, same in all the cases. Resistance, ammeter. Looks like all the diagrams are same. If all the diagrams are same, then definitely the current recorded by the ammeter in all the three cases is same. That is the answer. D, the same in all the cases, is the answer. Next, let us look at this. This is very interesting. I don't know whether you are able to see this. Just a moment. In the following circuits, heat produced in the resistor or combination of resistors connected to a 12 volt battery will be same in all the cases, minimum in case 1, maximum in case 2, and maximum in case 3. What is the heat produced over here? How do you calculate the heat produced? See, one logic I can use here, or actually how to calculate the heat produced. How do you calculate the heat produced basically? Here you can use H is equal to I square RT. You calculate the current, I square RT. Here also calculate the combination, RS equals 4 ohms and H is equal to I square RS into T. T you can take a constant over here. I hope you understand. You know, heat produced, T can be taken as a constant over here. Or you can calculate H by T, that is most preferable. Heat produced per unit time is the one which you can calculate, which is nothing but I square into R. So I square R, I square RS, I square RP. If you calculate, you will get heat produced per unit time. Then you can compare it. One logic I would like to use over here. What is constant in all these three cases? The resistance of the circuit is constant. And the voltage potential difference applied is constant. What varies? Current varies. And therefore, if I use H equals I square RT, if I changes, I cannot have I in the expression of heat per unit time. So I have to replace the variable which is a current with constant R and V. I hope you are able to understand. I would like to express the heat produced per unit time in terms of V and R. What is the formula for that? Let's see here. Yeah, let us solve on the board here. Question number 2. H equals I square RT. H by T equals I square R. IR into I into R into I, IR equals V into I. Now V, let me express this I in terms of V by R, which equals V square by R. This is H by T. The meaning of this here is the heat produced for unit time is inversely proportional to resistance if the potential difference applied is constant. In all the three cases, 12 volts is the potential difference applied, and therefore heat produced per unit time is dependent upon the resistance of the effective resistance of the circuit, and it is inversely proportional to the resistance. Case number 1, let me mark it R1. Case number 2, RS equals RS equals 4 ohms, circuit number 2, not case number 2. Circuit number 3, RP equals 1 ohm. You can calculate this one. RI equals here, I write R, 2 ohms. In circuit 1, resistance is 2 ohms. In circuit 2, resistance is 4 ohms. In circuit 3, resistance is 1 ohm. These are the effective resistances. Now you compare this one now. This is the greatest, greater. I am arranging in the descending order. RS is greater than R, circuit 1, which is greater than RP. As heat produced is inversely proportional to resistance, this is maximum resistance, so minimum heat. Therefore, least resistance is observed in parallel combination, maximum heat per unit time is produced in parallel combination. Therefore, this is RP, is circuit number 3 here. This is circuit 1, circuit 2, electric circuit 2, and this is electric circuit 3. Check yourself. Heat produced in circuit 3 is maximum compared to these two. So your answer should be D, maximum in circuit 3. Note it down. Third question. Electrical resistivity of a given metallic wire depends upon length? No. Thickness? No. Shape? No. Nature of material? Yes. Resistivity depends upon nature of material. Option D is correct. Next question, fourth one. Current of 1 ampere is drawn by a filament of an electric bulb. Number of electrons passing through a cross section of the filament in 16 seconds would be roughly, given data, current 1 ampere. Question is, number of electrons n you have to find out. 16 seconds time is given to us. I is equal to q by t. I equals n into e by t. Let me use that formula. This is fourth question. I equals q by t. N into e by t. Because q equals n into e. From this, the number of electrons passing d is given by n equals I into T over E. E is nothing but the charge of an electron. What is current? 1 ampere. Time 16 seconds divided by charge of an electron is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb, which is given by 16 into 10 to the power 19 divided by 1.6. 1.6 can be written as 16 into 10. 16 cancels. 10 to the power 20 is the answer. Is that option available? A. Therefore, A, 10 to the power 20 electrons. I hope you are understanding. Next question. Identify the circuit in which the electrical components have been properly connected. Let us analyze. See here, plus minus okay, ammeter plus minus okay, voltmeter cannot be connected in series. Wrong. This circuit, voltmeter across resistor okay, ammeter okay, plus minus, minus plus. Yeah, this circuit appears to be quite alright. Let us check further. This one, ammeter across resistor, not possible. Next, this also appears to be same, but let's see what is the difference between these two. Plus minus, minus here. Ammeter is wrong. The terminals, end terminals of the ammeters are wrong here. Here, minus here, so here it should be minus here, but it is plus. Therefore, this is wrong. Answer is 2. Next question. Answer is 2. B. What is the maximum resistance which can be made using 5 resistors, each of 1 by 5 ohms? What is the minimum resistance which can be made of using 5 resistors, each of 1 by 5 ohm? Question asked is maximum resistance with 1.5 with each of 1 by 5 ohm and minimum resistance with each of 1 by 5 ohm. How do you connect it? Dear students, many times I have told you in my earlier classes also, if the resistors are connected in series combination, the effective resistance is greater than the greatest value of the resistor. In parallel combination, the effective resistance is smaller than the least resistance. Question here, how do you obtain maximum resistance of resistors in combination? Connect them in series combination. So let me work out sixth one. Sixth one here I am working out. R equals 1 by 5. To get the maximum resistance, we have to connect all those things in the all these 5 resistors in series combination. So RS equals, how many times? 5 resistors. R plus R plus 5 times R, which equals 5 times 1 by 5, which equals 1 ohm. Is that option available? Yes. D, 1 ohm. If I connect resistors of 1 by 5 ohms each, 5 resistors in series combination, I get 1 ohm as the maximum resistance. So option D is the answer. Next I'll solve here itself. What is the minimum resistance to get? How do you get the minimum resistance? By connecting these resistors. Minimum resistance can be connected, minimum resistance can be obtained by connecting in parallel combination. So, seventh one, 1 by Rp equals 1 by 1 by 5 plus 1 by 1 by 5 plus 1 by 1 by 5 plus 1 by 1 by 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, plus one more last, which is nothing but how many times? 5 times, 1 over 1 by 5, 1 by 1 by 5, which equals 5 times into 5, which is 25, and therefore Rp equals, take a reciprocal, 1 over 25 ohms. Is that option available? Yes, B. Seventh question, B, 1 over 25 ohms. This is the least resistance that can be obtained. Let's go to the next question now. The proper representation of series combination of cells in these figures obtaining maximum potential is, we need to obtain the maximum potential and identify the correct diagram. If the cells are connected in series combination, the potential will get added up, will get the maximum potential. So by looking at this, first one, plus minus plus minus plus minus plus minus is the correct option. What about this? Negative to negative terminal, not possible. Here, plus minus plus minus minus plus, not possible. Here, not possible. This is the option 1, the correct option, where you can get the maximum potential by connecting all these cells in series combination. Next question. Which of the following represents voltage? Voltage is defined as work done in moving a unit charge from one point to another point. W by Q. Work done divided by Q. Work done by Q. What is Q equals? I equals Q by T. So Q equals I into T, and therefore W by I into T, W by I into T, where it is available? Work done divided by I into T. Option A is the correct one. Let us check. Work done into charge, W into Q, no. Work done into time by current, no. Work done into charge into time, no. Which of the following represents voltage? V equals W by Q. Q equals I into T. Option A, correct option. Now let us see. A cylindrical conductor of length L and uniform area of cross section A has a resistance R. Another conductor of length 2L and resistance R of the same material has area of cross section. We need to calculate the area of the cross section over here. Very interesting. This such numericals you can expect. What is given here? A cylindrical conductor of length L and area of cross section A has resistance R. Let me write down. So, a cylindrical conductor of length L and area of cross section A has resistance R, meaning R equals rho L by A. This is given to us. This is for a cylindrical conductor, L cross section area A, and the resistance is R. Another conductor of length 2L, another conductor of length 2L, L dash equals 2L, and resistance R. The resistance of this also should be how much? R. If that is the case, what is the area of the cross section? A dash equals question mark. I hope you are understanding. Here he has given a cylindrical conductor of length L and cross section area has a resistance R. What would be the cross section area of the second conductor when its resistance is same as the first one, but its length is 2 times the first one? So let me see here. R equals rho, L is 2L divided by A dash. I have to find out A dash, which equals 2 times rho, L by A dash. This is R because resistance is same for the both the things. This is what is given to you. And therefore, can I equate these two? Rho L by A equals 2 times rho L by A dash. Rho L cancels. A dash equals 2 times A. So the question is, what is the cross section area A dash, which equals 2 times the original cross section area? Therefore, option C, 2A, should be the correct one. Let us check the answer. Yeah, it is correct. Next question. I hope it is visible. Very important. A student carries out an experiment and plots the VI graph of 3 samples of nichrome wire with resistances R1, R2, R3 respectively. Which of the following is true? Are all these resistances equal? Or R1 is greater than R2, greater than R3? Greater than this, greater than this? Or R3 is greater than R2, R3 is greater than R2, and R2 is greater than R1, or R2 greater than R3? Some options have been given. We need to identify which one is the greatest over here. How do you identify? What is the graph given to you? Listen, dear friends, this is not VI graph. Here he said VI graph of 3 samples, but actual graph given to me is IV graph. Let me analyze this one. Question number 11. So IV graph has been given to us. R1, R2 and R3. This is I and V. IV graph gives you slope. IV graph gives you reciprocal of the resistance. Let me indicate the slopes of all these three as M1, M2 and M3. So, M1 equals 1 over R1. The IV graph gives you the reciprocal of the resistance. Is it right? So, I write like this. Basically, what is the question asked? We have to, which resistance is greater here? That is what it is given. So, slope of IV graph gives 1 upon resistance. That means slope is inversely proportional to the resistance, isn't it? Now, from the graphs, M1 is greater, then M2 is greater than M3. From graph, M1 is greater than M2, then M3. Is it right? If slope is greater like this, slope is inversely proportional to the resistance, and therefore R1 is smaller than R2 is smaller than R3. So, which one has the greatest the sequence we have to identify? Do we have this one? This is this is the correct option. Do we have this one? R1 less than R2, R1 less than R2, less than R3. Yes, option number C is available for us. Option C, how it is written here is R3 is greater than, R2 is greater than R1. Option C is the correct option. Once again, I would like to analyze, dear friends. Just listen here. IV graph is different from VI graph. In IV graph, we take the current on the y-axis and voltage across x-axis. The slope of the IV graph gives you the reciprocal of the resistance. Let me compare the slopes of R1, R2, R3 denoted by M1, M2, M3. Slope of R1 is greater. How do you say the slope of R1 is greater? It depends upon the angle of inclination. What is angle of inclination? Angle made by the graph or a straight line with positive direction of the x-axis is called the angle of inclination. More the angle of inclination, more is the slope. Angle of inclination of R1 is so much, which is more. Therefore, slope M1 is more greater than M2 and M3. So, by looking at the graphs, this is the arrangement of the slopes here. M1 is highest and M3 is least in terms of slopes. But slope is reciprocal, it gives the reciprocal of the resistance, or I can say inversely proportional to the resistance. Therefore, a graph having M1 resistor, which is highest slope here, has the least resistance. Highest slope has the least resistance because slope and resistance are inversely proportional. By looking at these slopes, we can arrange the order of the three resistors in this way, and rearranging, we get the option C. And please study these things, you'll get such questions basically. Okay, let's go to the next one. If the current I through a resistor is increased by 100%, assume that the temperature remains unchanged, the increase in power dissipated will be. Let us work out this. We'll start solving here. 12th one. Power dissipated through a resistor is given by P equals I square into R. Let this be P1. If I is increased by 100%, meaning I dash equals 2 times I, and therefore P2 equals I dash square into R, which equals 2i the whole square into R, 4i square R, 4 times P1. This is P2 equals 4 times P1. The question is, the increase in power dissipated will be, the increase in power dissipated we need to calculate. See here, increase in power dissipated equals, which is nothing but percentage increase, equals increase divided by original or initial, you can say initial power into 100. What is the increase? final power minus initial power divided by initial power, the whole thing into 100, which equals, what is the final power? P2 minus P1 divided by P1 into 100. What is P2 here? P2 equals 4P1. 4P1 minus P1 divided by P1 into 100, which is 3P1 divided by P1 into 100, which is 300%. Therefore, is that option available? C, 300% is the answer for this. So let's go to the next one. The resistivity does not change if the material is changed. If the material is changed, resistivity changes. The temperature is changed, resistivity changes. The shape of the resistor is changed. If the shape of the resistor is changed, resistivity does not change, because it is independent of the size and shape. Both material and temperature are changed. If both are changed, resistivity changes. So only in one case the resistivity does not change, that is, the shape of the resistor is changed. Option C is the correct answer. Next. In an electric circuit, three incandescent bulbs A, B, C of rating 40 watts, 60 watts, 100 watts are respectively connected in parallel to an electric source. Which of the following is likely to happen regarding their brightness? Brightness of all the bulbs will be same. Brightness of bulb A will be maximum. Brightness of bulb B will be more than A. And brightness of C will be less than that of B. Look at this. In parallel combination, the desired voltage is met by the source voltage. The voltage across each bulb remains same, and therefore higher the power, more the brightness. Higher the power, that bulb glows more brightly, and therefore simply here 100 watt glows more brighter than 60 watt, than 40 watt. Brightness of all the bulbs will be same? Wrong. Brightness of A will be maximum. A is 40 watts. Wrong. Brightness of B will be more than A. 60 watts is more than A. Correct. Brightness of C will be less than that of B. Brightness of C will be less than that of B. Wrong. Therefore, brightness of B will be more than that of A. 60 watt bulb is more brighter than 40 watts. Option C is the correct answer. Next. In an electrical circuit, two resistors, 2 ohms, 4 ohms respectively, are connected in series to a 6 volt battery. The heat dissipated by the 4 ohm resistor in 5 seconds will be H equals I square into R is 4 ohm into time. We'll get it. But you have to find out I here. So let's work out 15 questions. Given two resistors R1 2 ohm, R2 4 ohms, they are connected in series to a battery of 6 volts. This is 2 ohm, this is 4 ohms, R1, R2. What is the connection? The heat dissipated by 4 ohm resistor in 5 seconds will be. How much is heat dissipated here? H equals question mark. In order to find H equals I square RT over here, I square into R2 into T. What is this I here? It should flow. Whatever that flows through the 4 ohm resistor. How do you get that? This current. First find out the equivalent resistance. RS equals 6 ohms. And therefore, V equals I into RS, I equals V by RS, 6 by 6, 1 ampere. And therefore, H equals the same 1 ampere current flows across R1, R2. The current over here is 1 amps, 1 amp, the whole square into R2, 4 into time is 5 seconds. which equals 20 joules. 20 joules. Option C. 20 joules is the correct answer. Next one. An electric kettle consumes 1 kilowatt of electric power when operated at 220 volts. A fuse wire of what rating must be used for it? In order to do so, based on the power rating, calculate the safe limiting current. How do you calculate? P equals VI, I equals P by V. Calculate the safe limiting current, and the fuse rating should be slightly greater than the safe limiting current. So let us work out now. 16th question. Electric kettle consumes 1 kilowatt. Power equals 1 kilowatt, which equals 1000 watts. Voltage 220 volt. Safe limiting current P equals VI, and therefore I equals P by V. P is 1000 divided by 220. Let me work out for you. amps. So out of 4.545 amps, the current should be greater than the fuse rating should be greater than this current. Option D, 5 amps. Option D, 5 amps, which is greater than 4.545, is able to withstand and electric kettle can work comfortably. For all other cases, 1 amp, 2 amp, 4 amp, the fuse will blow off because the current drawn will be more than fuse, the rating, current rating of the fuse wire. The current drawn by the kettle will be more than the fuse rating, and hence it will blow off. Therefore, 5 amp, option D is the correct one. Next one. Two resistors of 2 ohms and 4 ohms when connected to a battery will have same current flowing connected to a battery. Two resistors of resistance 2 ohms and 4 ohms when connected to a battery will have same current flowing through them when connected in parallel. Not possible. Parallel, I1, I2 will be different. Same current flowing through them when connected in series. Yes, option B is correct. Same potential difference across them when connected in series. No, when connected in series, the potential difference is different. Different potential difference across them when connected in parallel. No, when those are connected in parallel, potential difference remains same. Therefore, the only option is same current flowing through them when connected in series is the correct answer. Next question, 18th. Unit of electric power may also be expressed as volt amp. Correct. Kilowatt hour, kWh. No, because kWh is the energy, whereas volt ampere is power. Watt second. What is watt second? Unit of electric power may also be expressed as, power is watts basically. Watt second can be expressed as watt second, wrong. Joule second, wrong. Kilowatt hour, wrong. Volt amp, correct. Option A is the correct answer. Next. Nineteenth question. You yourself work out the 19th question because it's quite simple. 20th question. Three 2 ohm resistors A, B, C are connected as shown in figure 12.7 over here. Each of them dissipates energy and can withstand a maximum power of 18 watts without melting. Find the maximum current that can flow through the three resistors. What will you do here? The three resistors are there. The maximum power of each of them dissipates energy and can withstand a maximum power of 18 watts. Each can withstand a maximum power of 18 watts without melting. Find the maximum current that can flow through the three resistors. Let me work out here. 20th. Question is, 2 ohms, 2 ohms, 2 ohms. Power maximum 18 watts. So power equals, power across each resistor is given by I square R. Therefore, I square equals P by R. What is the value of each resistors? 2 ohm. So maximum current that can pass through each resistor is calculated by I square equals P by R. P is 18 watts divided by R is 2 ohms, which is 9. Therefore, I equals under root of 9, only plus we have to take here, and therefore 3 amps. Therefore, please remember, maximum current that can pass through 2 ohm resistor is 3 amps. If 3, therefore, I will say here, has a given name there, ABC, AB and C, okay. Therefore, maximum current through A is 3 amps, maximum current through B is, as these two are same resistors or the same values, the current will gets divided equally. If this is 3 amps over here, 1.5 amps. So I equals here 1.5 amps and I here also equals 1.5 amps. So maximum current through B and C equals 1.5 amps. 1.5 plus 1.5, 3 amps. If I consider 3 amps over here, then 3 amps plus 3 amps put together 6 amps through this, this will blow off because 6 amps it cannot withstand. Maximum power is only 18 watts. Maximum current that can pass through this is also 3 amps. So, if a 3 amps can flow through this resistor, then which will get divided into equally because of these same resistors, 1.5 amps, 1.5 amps. And therefore, maximum current through A is 3 amps, maximum current through B and C, 1.5 amps. Please check the answer, it is correct. Next one. Should the resistance of an ammeter be low or high? Give reason. Ammeter is a device used to measure the electric current, and therefore its resistance should be, we expect the resistance of an ammeter to be approximately zero here. Why it is so? Least the resistance, it will not affect the true current, and therefore the value of the resistance should be as low as possible. We expect it to be approximately zero here. So should the resistance of the ammeter be low or high? It should be low. Give reason, otherwise it will not give the true value of the current. Next. Draw the circuit diagram for electric circuit containing a cell, an ammeter, a resistor of 2 ohms in series with the combination of two resistors of 4 ohm in parallel and a voltmeter across the parallel combination. Will the potential difference across the 2 ohm resistors be same as that across the parallel combination of 4 ohm resistors? Give reason. Let us draw the circuit here. 2 ohm in series with a combination of two resistors of 4 kilo ohm. This is question number 22. Two ohms, four ohms, four ohms. This is the circuit diagram. Voltmeter across the parallel combination. Here the voltmeter is connected across the parallel combination. And a cell, key, ammeter, everything. This is the circuit diagram. Now, what is the question asked? Will the potential difference across 2 ohm resistors be same as that across the parallel combination of 4 ohm resistors? Is the potential difference across 2 ohm is same as this one? Is the question. See here, let us see. 4 ohms, 4 ohms, parallel combination. What is the potential difference across this one? The same voltage whichever apply, that will be the potential difference. Question is the potential difference across 2 ohms and this combination is same? Once again, is the potential difference across 2 ohm and this combination is same. Please work out the combination of these two resistors. What is the value of this one? 2 ohms. Is that it? These are in connection. Rp equals 2 ohms. Here also it is 2 ohm. Therefore, as these two are same resistors, that way the potential difference, the potential drop across this is equal to the potential drop across this. I can replace this circuit by something like this. This is also 2 ohms. This is also 2 ohms. Is there a potential difference drop, potential drop across these two resistors is same? Yes, it is same. Why? Because both the values are same. If V1 equals, this is V1 and this is V2, current will remain same across these two. IR1, V2 equals IR2. As R1, R2 are same, V1, V2 is same. I hope you are understanding. R1 equals R2, therefore potential difference across these two is same. Only thing is, we have to calculate the effective resistance of these two and consider over here. And therefore, the question answer to this question is, will the potential difference across 2 ohm resistors be the same as across the parallel combination of 4 ohm resistors? Yes, because the effective resistance of the parallel combination of resistors is also a 2 ohm, which is same as the resistor that is connected in series combination. Hence, potential difference across the two is same. Next question. How does use of a fuse wire protect electrical appliances? Question is, how does use of a fuse wire protect electrical appliances? If the electrical current more than the rated current flows in a circuit, due to Joule's law of heating, the temperature of the fuse wire increases above the melting point of the fuse wire, and therefore the fuse wire melts, the circuit is cut off, and hence it will protect the appliances from the flow of high current. Next, what is an electrical resistivity? In series electrical circuit comprising a resistor made up of metallic wire, the ammeter reads 5 amps. The reading of the ammeter decreases to half when the length of the wire is doubled. Why? Here, what is the electrical resistivity? It is the characteristic property of the material, which remains same irrespective of the size and shape and dimensions of the resistance. That is called electrical resistivity, or you can define like this. Electrical resistivity of a material is defined as the resistance of a wire which is made up of that material whose cross-section area is 1 square unit and whose length is 1 meter, 1 unit. And therefore, that is how we can define. In a series electrical circuit comprising a resistor made up of a metallic wire, the ammeter reads 5 amps. Okay? The reading of the ammeter decreases to half when the length of the wire is doubled, because the relationship between I and R is inverse relation. So, if the ammeter, the reading of the ammeter decreases to half in the length of the wire. If the length of the wire is doubled, the resistance increases to twice. I and R are inversely proportional, therefore the current decreases to half. And hence, the reading shown by the ammeter decreases to half if the length of the resistor is doubled. Shall I explain once again? Here, the wire is doubled. So, resistance is 2 times. I and R are inversely proportional. If the resistance increases by twice, then the current increases to half. That is the answer for that. Next, 24th. What is commercial unit of electrical energy? Kilowatt hour is called the commercial unit of energy. Represent it in terms of joules, 3.6 megajoules. Next. A current of 1 ampere flows in a circuit containing an electric lamp and a conductor of 5 ohms when connected to 10 volt battery. Calculate the resistance of the electric lamp. Let us calculate. Question number 26. 1 amp flows in a series circuit containing an electric lamp, one electric lamp and one conductor which is 5 ohms. These are connected to in a series to a battery of 10 volts. What is the question asked? Calculate the resistance of the electric lamp. R. R1, R2. Calculate R1. These two are in series combination. RS equals R1 plus R2, which equals R1 plus 5. Now V equals I into RS. What is given current is 1 ampere. I equals 1 ampere. So V equals, what is V here? 10 volt, 1 ampere into RS. So 10 equals RS implies, what is RS here? R1 plus 5. 10 equals R1 plus 5 implies R1 equals 10 minus 5, which is equal to 5 ohms. So this is 5 ohms. This is one way of calculation. An alternate way also I'll tell you how to calculate. If 1 ampere current flows through this circuit, what is the voltage of this voltage drop across R2? V2 equals I into R2, which is 1 ampere into 5, which equals 5 volts. So V2 equals 5 volts. Let it be V1 here. V1 plus V2 equals 10 volts. So V1 is what we want, 10 minus V2, which is 10 minus 5, which is equal to 5 volts. So we got V1 equals 5 volts. What is V1 is equal to? V1 equals I into R1. V1 is 10 volts, 1 amp into R1. Therefore, R1 equals, R1 is just a moment. What is that we have to calculate? R1 we have to calculate, isn't it? So R1 equals V1 by, just a moment, V1 is 5, correct. 5 by 1, which is 5 ohm, it is correct. So this is how both the ways you can calculate. The answer is, resistance of the electric bulb is 5 ohms. Next, second part you work out yourself of that. Next we'll go to 27th. Why is parallel arrangement used in domestic wiring? This has been explained many times. If the appliances are connected in parallel combination, even if the one appliance is not working, rest of the appliances will work. Second thing, the same thing can be said like this also. In parallel combination, if one of the appliances fails to work or if one of the appliances is switched off, then operation of rest of the appliances is not affected. That you can say. And also you can say, the appliances with different voltage, appliances with proper voltage requirement with different current requirements are met in parallel combination than in series combination. Therefore, these are the two reasons. Question number 28. B1, B2, B3 are three identical bulbs. B1, B2, B3 are three identical bulbs. When all the three bulbs glow, a current of 3 amp is recorded by ammeter A. This records 3 amps current. See, these three are identical bulbs. When all these three bulbs glow, the current recorded by the main ammeter is 3 amps. I can conclude by that way, current flowing across B1 is 1 amp, across B2 is 1 amp, across B3 is 1 amp. I1 plus I2 plus I3 equals 3 amps. When all the three bulbs glow, the current indicated by the main ammeter is 3 amps, meaning definitely I1 equals I2 equals I3 equals 1 amp. What happens to the glow of the other two bulbs when B1 gets fused? When B1 gets fused, B2 and B3 glow normally because these are in parallel combination. If the current stops in case of B1, definitely it can still be flowing through B2 and B3. So B2 and B3, nothing happens to the glowing of the bulbs B2 and B3 if B1 is fused. What happens to reading of A1, A2, A3 and A when the bulb gets fused? When bulb B2 gets fused. When bulb B2 gets fused, what happens to A1? Nothing happens to A1, 1 ampere it will show. A2, 0, because B2 is fused. A2 is 0, no current flows because it is fused. Fused means short circuited, or you can say fused in the sense there is no current which can flow through that. And A3 1 ampere, it is showing 1 ampere plus 1 ampere, 2 ampere it will be showing. That is the answer for this one. How much power is dissipated in the circuit when all the three bulbs glow together? All the three bulbs glow together. Power equals I square into R. What else is given to us? 3 ampere is given. And how much power is dissipated in the current circuit when all the three bulbs glow together? Power dissipated in the circuit is I square into R. Isn't it? I square into R. R we have to find out here. Just a moment, what is given? Power equals V into I, also you can do 4. We are given here 4.5 volts. Current is 3 amps. So 4.5 into 3 amps is the power dissipated through these 3 bulbs. That is 4.5 into 3. That is how much about? How much it is? 4.5 into 3. 13.5 watts is the power dissipated in the electrical circuit. Dear friends, from 29th onwards till the 35 questions, till 35th questions, these are all mainly conceptual questions. All the concepts have been discussed very clearly. All the concepts have been discussed very clearly and explained also. My suggestion would be, you please go through question number 29 till the end. I think about 35 questions are there. If you have any difficulty, please get back to me. Here, let us close this chapter. I have explained the entire concepts, all the concepts of this chapter. I have taken you through all the questions of textbook, that is in-text questions and exercise questions. And also, I have taken almost all the questions through exemplar numericals. And also, I have covered most important numericals part with a title like important numericals. So, lot of things have been worked out for this. Dear students, please study hard. Go through my video lectures again and again, especially the numerical parts. Okay? Otherwise, it will be very difficult for you to understand and solve the numericals. Please go through the numerical lectures again and again and master them. So, let us end the session and see you with the next chapter in the next lecture. Thank you.